Good evening and welcome to Game Over.
Hello.
It's Tuesday and that can only mean one thing.
What?
No, you're absolutely right, it doesn't mean anything. Let's start again, shall we? Good evening and welcome to Game Over.
Hello.
It's Tuesday and while that's not particularly significant in itself, we got a whole new show of gaming delights to offer you.
It'll be halfway over if you don't get on with it.
Point taken. Here's tonight's menu.
First up in tonight's reviews, we go to hell and back with Spawn the Eternal. There's beat-em-up action in the second review slot of Versus. And our feature brings you a preview of Road Rash 3D.
Right, sorry about that slightly confusing opening link. And as I'm here, I suppose I'd better apologise for the last 4 months of slightly confusing links.
What Ronnie calls confusing, I call poetic.
And some other people would what call it self-indulgent ranting of a man who has no other purpose on this earth.
What Ronnie patently fails to realise is that my links have attracted high praise.
From whom?
From these people.
The National Society of Poetic and Overly Serious Young Men?
Yep, NAPOSism for short.
Whatever you say, dear. Whatever you say.
Welcome to the R-Files. Our agents have been investigating new games releases to see if they pose a threat to national security or if they leave the world safe to rest easy in its beds for another night. Government secret agent and assassin L. Simmons is double-crossed by superiors and discovers that the reward for a life of wickedness is to be committed to the depths of hell in the employ of the devil. It's here that a new kind of hero is born, Spawn. In the game, you must help Spawn escape his evil masters and bring justice to the streets of New York.
Spawn the Eternal is on the PlayStation. Spawn, in case you didn't know, is one of the most successful comic licenses of the 90s. It's everywhere. It sells millions of copies all of it, and now it's finally arrived on your PlayStation. It's decidedly disappointing. The graphics are about that close to being good. The gameplay control system is very annoying. Basically what it is, your character's running around, and whenever you need to turn left or right, you have to stop to turn left or right. You travel around one of four different chapters, dimensions, and when you bump into a character, it switches to a beat-em-up mode, which at first was a nice touch, and I was quite excited by it, but then you suddenly realise the limited moves you have. You can practically walk through this whole game just kicking people. That's all you have to do. You don't need any special moves. But then you think, no, spend the money, I'm going to try and make this a bit better. So you suddenly realise that as you go around, you pick up all these special glowing balls that let you do special moves in the game. The novelty of them lasts for a very, very short amount of time. And then it just becomes dross. There's not much storyline to it. There's not much to keep you involved. And eventually it just becomes boring.
I've got to agree with you. It very much so is a complete waste of time and money. It doesn't even look that great. There are an awful lot of 3D adventures around at the moment, an awful lot of 3D beat-em-ups. And this falls very, very short of the mark. It doesn't look that great. It doesn't play that great. The camera angles I found really, really annoying. The way in which the camera moved, It was very, very juddery. It did obscure a lot of the action. I didn't enjoy it at all. And I wouldn't really recommend that you invest in it.
It's beat-em-up time for the PlayStation again in this new martial arts title, Versus. Any fans of this genre will know what to expect. Male and female characters thrown into a ring with one simple thought on their minds. Two men enter and one man leaves.
the moment, all everyone is doing is talking about racing games on the PlayStation. And this is a fighting game. It'll be a nice break. And it is actually quite a nice game. I came into it thinking it's not really going to be, and, you know, my mind is on other games such as Tekken 3. But this was very smooth. There wasn't really a very amazing array of characters, but it was an amazing array of fighting skills and styles, which was good. So you know that each character is going to be different. It was colourful, it was fast, the combos were easy to pull out. It was everything you'd want, really, in a fighting game. It didn't push the genre much, I thought, but it did enough for it.
Everything that Agent Thompson said is correct. I, on the other hand, am a little bit harder to please. It did look very nice, and it is quite smooth. And the graphics themselves are a little bit on the chunky side. It's no Tekken 3, that's for sure. But if you want another fighting game in your library, and you could do worse than this one, but it's not great by any stretch of the imagination.
We sit and we discourse.
Discourse?
Discourse.
Discourse what exactly?
I don't know, life, love, politics.
All right, all
trout
right.
Fishing,
I get the picture.
Local geography.
Okay.
Wardrobes, Lego.
Richard, okay.
Marshmallows, Scott F. Fitzgerald.
Richard,
wire strippers.
All right. Now please, escape into the feature, as this could take a little while.
To the world of Road Rash 3D. Get ready for a full contact, teeth clenched blast around the highways and byways of the US. The game takes the form of a fast and furious combat racer with motion captured animations and an accurate physics model of all of the motorbikes involved in the game. And just to ensure that you stay interested in the game, there's over 100 miles of interconnected roads to ride over. The final weapon this game has is that your ears can be assaulted by a hard rock soundtrack.
Well, hello there, gaming fanatics. I'm the Games Tipstress. I'm here tonight to bring an end to all of your video gaming woes with the help of some fantastic tips and some tender loving care. So who stands before me tonight in need of my
wisdom? Games Tipstress, can you help? I've got Earthworm Jim on the PC, but I find I can't survive long enough to reach some of the later levels. I need your help.
So you're a fan of wriggly little characters too. I knew I wasn't alone in my fondness for worms and such like. Well, let's see what I can do for you. During the game, type in "It's a Wonderful" and an extra life will be awarded to you. You can repeat this procedure any time you need to with the same results. But just in case you're a fan of childish animation, type "Hatman" to change Jim into a stick man. Well, my time here is over for tonight. I think I'll conduct some further investigations into the fun that can be derived from little pink worms. Until next time, good night.
Well, that's the end of another show. The darkness is drawing in all around us. Or as somebody once wrote, night's black agents to their praise do rouse.
That's Macbeth, isn't it?
Nah, ignoramus, it's Shakespeare. You learn that sort of thing in the society. Right, that's it from us. Goodbye, or as we say in the society, bon nuit.
Pardon?
Bon nuit, it's French for...
For
bon nuit. Sweet nut.
Whatever. Good night.
Sweet night.